What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com. Today in this tutorial, we will learn how to uninstall Oracle Database 11g from Windows 10 64-bit version. Though I am performing this Oracle 11g uninstallation on Windows 10 64-bit, but you can also follow this same process for Windows 10 32-bit version, as steps are the same. That being said, let's see how to uninstall Oracle 11g from Windows 10. If you are planning to reinstall the Oracle database and do not want to face the error which says environment variable path is too long, then in that case, you must delete the variable beforehand so that your next installation is smooth and glitch free. So let's see how to delete Oracle 11g environment variable. First, right click on your This PC icon in Windows 10 and select Properties. Once you are into the properties of your computer, then select the Advanced System Settings from the left-hand sidebar. Doing so will open up the system properties. There is a button called Environment Variable at the bottom of the Advanced tab of System Properties. Click this button and launch the Environment Variable window. On this window, we have two sections that are User Variables and System Variables. Come to the System Variables section and find a variable with the name path. Double click and open the Edit Environment Variable window. In Windows 10, environment variables are better organized in comparison to previous versions, which make their management less painful. Anyways, you must be wondering, among all these strings, which one is the environment variable for Oracle 11g and which one should you delete? In my case, the environment variable for my Oracle database looks like this. In your case also, it should look more or less similar to this string, but depending on your installation, it can be different. Whatsoever, at least you get the idea. So select the string you want to delete and press the delete button. That's all you have to do in the first step. Once you are done with the environment variable, the next thing which you have to delete is the Windows registries for Oracle database software. This step is very crucial and meticulous. You have got to be very careful while deleting the registries. One wrong move can cause severe damage. So let's see how to delete Oracle database 11g's Windows registries. First, open up your run command box by pressing Windows key and R key simultaneously. In order to open up the registry editor in your Windows, you have to write regedit in your run dialog box. Press OK. And here we are. There are two sets of registries that we have to delete here. One is for Oracle Database 11g software, and another one is for all those services which runs in the background and are responsible for proper working of your Oracle database. Let's start with the later option and delete the registries for Oracle Database services first. To delete these service registries, first go to /key_local_machine directory and then go to system subdirectory. After that, go to current control set. And then services. Here in this services directory, you will find all the registries which we have to delete. In order to find the registries for Oracle database services from this list, press alphabet O on your keyboard. And navigation will take you to all those registries whose name starts with O. And luckily, all the Oracle database registries name starts with the word Oracle. For Oracle Database 11g, we have 8 Windows registries. Make sure to delete only these and nothing else. To delete these registries, right-click on them and choose Delete. Do the same with all these 8 registries. So as we have deleted all the Oracle Database Services registries, now it's time to get rid of Windows registries for Oracle Database software. And to delete that registry, again come back to /key_local_machine folder. And this time, go to the folder Software. The name of the registry which we are looking here is Oracle. So again press alphabet O and find the same. Here it is. Let me expand this registry for you. Okay, just give me a second. Great. Okay, But before deleting this registry, make sure only Oracle Database 11g software is installed in your system. In case if you have other software from Oracle installed, then take a good look at the content of this folder and delete those only. Anyways, taking a backup of registries is highly recommended. You can learn how to take the backup of your Windows registries and other interesting stuff by reading the blog on the same topic on my website. Link is in the description. That being said, let's delete this folder. Okay, done. So now all the registries of your Oracle 11g have been deleted. Next, in order to bring these changes to effect, you must restart your system. So I am going to restart my system. We'll be back in a second. Here I am. My system is restarted and all set to jump ahead on third step. So as we have now deleted all the Oracle registries, so we are free to delete all the Oracle database folders from our Windows 10. Let's do it. So locate the base directory of your Oracle database. In most of the cases, the name of the base directory of Oracle is app, and it's located directly in the C drive or in the main drive where your OS is installed. Here is mine. Now delete this directory. In case you are stuck and it won't delete, then don't panic. Take a deep breath, restart your system and try deleting again. Also, make sure you have done all the above steps properly, or you can try deleting the files in Windows safe mode. Okay. Oracle Home is deleted. Next, go to the program file folder and here find the directory with the name Oracle and delete that also. Here is mine. And it's deleted. Next, we have to delete the start menu entry for Oracle database. To do that, go to the location which is flashing on your screen in your Windows 10. Don't worry if you missed it, as you can find this location path in the description below as well as on my blog. Once you are here, find your Oracle database folder and delete it. Here is mine. Let's delete this. Done. Now your Windows 10 is completely free from Oracle database. That's how we uninstall Oracle database 11g from Windows 10. For more in-depth knowledge, I suggest you head over to my website. There I have explained each step in detail and covered all the interview questions. I'm sure you will enjoy reading that. Find the link in the description. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then make sure to hit the thumbs up button. Also, help others in learning by sharing this video on your social media. Most importantly, subscribe. Thanks once again. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.